Today, I will work with a file containing data about greenhouse gas emissions, grouped by country, year, and gas type. From that file, I would like to extract the data concerning sulfur hexafluoride emissions in each available country, and compare the emissions for the year 1990 and the year 2000. Extracting the relevant data is not very difficult using the grep command. But as you may see it, the lines are not properly aligned because of missing data. So we need a way to match lines by their country code. If you're familiar with relational databases, you may have recognized the join operation. But don't panic. We will not spawn a new database instance just for that purpose. As you will see it, you can perform join operations on text data files straight from your shell using the well-named join command. Given my needs, I cannot really use the paste command since it simply combines the lines of two files based on their position. Here instead, I will need the join command. For the join command to work, we need to specify the field separator used in the data files, and for each input file, which field contains the key. And I could run the command just like that. But I'm not too fond of temporary files. Just to name a few disadvantages, you have to remember to delete them after usage, and they require write permissions on the directories they are created. Of course, this is not totally unmanageable, but I still prefer using bash process substitutions instead to let my shell handle the nitty-gritty details for me. And here it is. I have now, on the same line, the data joined by their country code. But the output format is far from being perfect. That's not really an issue since, with the join command, we can choose which field to display in the output. Here, the zero field is a join field, and the other fields are specified using the fileNumber.FieldNumber format. One thing to notice here is, in that output, only lines having a corresponding key in both tables are displayed. This is called an inner join. But the join command can perform left, right, and full outer joins too. This is particularly useful when you have missing values. To fully understand the notion of join, you must first understand the notion of Cartesian product. The Cartesian product of two tables is simply the set of all combinations you can build by taking a row from the first table and a row from the second table, regardless of their content. Sometimes the Cartesian product is called a cross join. The other forms of join are a little bit more selective in their output, since they will look at the raw content to decide if a given pair will or will not be part of the output. You already know the inner join we've seen before. This one will keep only pairs having the same value in their key fields. A left join will produce the same result as an inner join, but with the addition of all rows from the left table that don't have a match in the right table. To build the result set, the missing data from the right table will be assigned some default value. A right join is exactly the same thing, but with the left and right tables reversed. Finally, a full outer join will keep non-matching rows from both tables. In my particular case, I know some countries didn't report the values for the 1990 sulfur hexafluoride emissions. So I would like to keep all values for the year 2000 and mark the missing values for the year 1990 as not available. I'll let you a few seconds to think about the type of join I will need here. Okay. Said differently, in my case, I have rows in the 2000 table that don't have a match in the 1990 table. Given the 2000 table is the right one in my command, I need a right join. At this point, I have mostly achieved what I wanted, but in order to have a more nicely formatted result, I would like to replace the country code by the actual country name. And guessed it, I can perform the replacement using another join operation. So I will take my first join and use it as an input for a second join operation. And this failed with the join command complaining about the country file not being sorted. This is a limitation of the join command. Both your input files must be sorted according to the join key. We didn't have any issue until now because, by luck, the greenhouse gas emission data file was already sorted by country code. However, this is not the case for the country file. But using the sort command, it is not very difficult to solve that problem. Probably we can still improve the result by removing the gas type field, for example, or by replacing the chemical formula by the actual gas name. But I left that for you to practice. And once you'll be a little bit more comfortable with that, it will be time to take my challenge for this video. Starting from the provided CSV data files and using the join command, I would like you to display the greenhouse gas emission for Estonia in 1990. I expect exactly that result. And as always, I'm really looking forward to reading your solution in the comment section below.